Welcome to this movie about finite-element based thickness in 3-matic. In this movie we'll run over the steps in the most efficient order to perform the finite-element based thickness. This starts with importing file, a possible remesh and a volume mesh for your analysis afterwards, creating lightweights, performing the analysis, importing these results and applying the finite-element based thickness. A remesh can be done for your analysis. Here you see an image of a good quality and a bad quality. Now in 3-matic we will show you how to perform the remesh. Under the remesh toolbar you will have here the adaptive remesh. So what you do is you select the frame and you apply the remesh. It will calculate remesh for the triangle edge. We can also create a volume mesh for our analysis. So you can see here an image of a high quality volume mesh. So first we'll show you that we have an empty shell. This can be done with a section, so I have to show it and then enable clipping. And if we turn the part, you can see here that the part has been clipped. Of course we have to position our section a little bit so you can see that it is empty inside. The red indicates the inside and the inside is empty. Now, if you want to apply a volume mesh, here you have to choose Create Volume Mesh. Then you select your entity and you apply. And to apply it according to the properties. So we will create a tetrahedral element with 4 points, so a tet4 element. Now, once this has been applied, you can see that volume mesh is now inside of the part. So you can see here these different volume elements, volume finite elements, inside the part. Okay, if I disable the clipping, of course the volume mesh is still inside. Next we want to create a lightweight structure. So this is done by applying a unit cell inside a certain volume. So let's apply our lightweight in 3-matic. First I want to show you the volume. So this volume, and let's deactivate the mesh, this volume right here, that's the volume that we want to replace by a graph. First we need our unit cell, that's the red part, and this unit cell we want to repeat. So with create unit graph I will create the in this part, and then the graph set will be inside unit cell cubicle, and I can change its size. So we see here if I fill in different value, then you see can see in green how big it will become. Then for the method can be uniform but also randomized a bit, random deviation from normal, and you can keep the original surface or not. So we will remove it. Then if we apply it, the unit cell will be repeated and it will replace the volume. Okay, what's very important now, if I would check my result, my graph, you see that it has no thickness, and if it doesn't have a thickness then it has the red color. So you can see here in the slide, no thickness, red color. So we still want to apply this thickness. Okay, to apply this thickness, we're going to go to Lightweights and then Graph to AM Build. And here I select my entity and the thickness which I want to apply. So I can fill it in here. If I choose Apply, then you see that it receives a color, because it now has a thickness, it's no longer red. So you can see here nicely the thickness. It has now a uniform thickness. Okay, then for the next step, so now we want to use our analysis results. So first we will have to export our model to finite element package and then import the results. Okay, so file, export, I will choose ABAQUS. So if I have selected the entity and the frame of course, then I can export this mesh and the volume, so everything I've created, the graphs, I can use it by part. And okay, assembly, I will now choose where to save it, so on my desktop, and save, apply, and that's it. Now I've exported to ABAQUS. So I exported it to a file which I can load in ABAQUS. Okay, so let's say you have done the analysis, I want to import it. Okay, in the demo files you can use here your part which you want to use and apply. Then the result from ABAQUS is loaded back in into 3-matic. That's the result that you can see here. It contains analysis results, so let's show them. And you can see here nicely in the color which values it has received in ABAQUS. So you can see here also in the graph which what results you received back. Now we want to apply thickness based on these results so that parts which have more stress get another thickness. So to do this, you go to lightweights and then we have finite element based thickness. So you choose your entity. You have to choose the graph. Then for the NLs, you choose a certain result. You have here your global parameters. But in your expert mode, you can also say that for certain other values, you have a local range of parameters. So if I now apply it, then elements will receive a thickness based on the amount of stress result which it has there. So we can see here it corresponds to my graph results. Okay, now that we applied the thickness, you want to convert your graph to STL. If you use our build processor, that's not required. But if you want to do it, of course we can. You have to be under lightweights STL. So you choose your graph. And then if I load in my graph, it will also find the thicknesses which have been applied. Okay, here I can set my accuracy and I'm going to apply it. Now it is converted to STL. Of course, for a nice result, you want to use a smooth operation. So we've already done this. We have improved the result a little bit, so we get a very nice view. So now this has been loaded in, and you can see here with a little bit of smoothing, as you see there, smooth and subdivide, you have now a very nice result, which nicely shows in small triangles how the graph should be printed. So what we have shown you is the best way to import a file, apply remesh and volume mesh, create lightweights, export it and import it for your analysis, and apply thickness and convert it to STL. Thank you for your attention.